Alright, ladies and gentlemen, so in this video I will be showing you how to farm large Deralium shards in Lords of the Fallen. And what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to go to the Fen Bog location or Vestige, and from then on I will show you where to go. Okay, so first things first, let's just get past this damn loading screen. For the main part of it, you're going to want to be in the Umbral Realm. It's not really necessary to be in it the whole time. However, in order to access one of the key parts to getting there, you're definitely going to want to be in the Umbral Realm, as you see here. And then there is a ladder at the beginning that you have to go up, and unfortunately, you can only see that if you're in the Umbral Realm. Also, I'll be talking about my build later on in the video, but as you can see, note to self, always make sure the pointy part connects with wherever you are trying to hit, as I failed over there. But anyways, here's the ladder that I was talking about. Then go, and there's two or three enemies along your path. However, you do not need to go for or go through them. And oh, there we are, so rudely interrupted by one of these damn mobs. There we go, take that. But anyways, continuing, you just run, continuing into the Umbral Realm, and then these two enemies up ahead, you don't really have to engage with them. They won't trigger if you just run past them. However, for the sake of just showing some gameplay or fun combat in the game and showing off my awesome build, which I'm pretty much sucking at, we're just going to kill them for a bit. But okay, continuing. Now, this is the part where you're actually going to get the large Deralium shards. Now, first things first, try to whatever weapon you're using, make sure you buff it up, because these guys are pretty tanky, especially if you are in the early game. Even with my level 86, I think, character, it still takes a bit of know-how to get through them. So first, hit the wooden block, then you'll see one of these big guys. And then you just hit them with all you got. Now, also, you can't lock onto them once you break the wood. And here we should see Deralium.
I say, hold up, wait a minute, something ain't right.
All right, now I've got to be honest with you. Unfortunately, Hexworks has patched this farm. So these enemies no longer give you anything. And the next few minutes will literally show me actually figuring out that this method does not work anymore, and that these enemies do not drop large Deralium shards anymore. I don't know if it's capped to a certain limit. I myself got maybe 10 in total, 10 or so, maybe more. But yeah. Just cannot seem to get any more, and for the next few minutes you're just going to be hearing a lot of Robert D. Weide and Darude Sandstorm to show my frustration at not getting large Deralium shards, and therefore rendering this video absolutely damn useless. However, at the end I will talk a bit more about my build, and at least there's a light at the end of the tunnel. Thank you. Alright, now as you can see, zero large Deralium shards obtained. However, at the end I did get a nice little helmet, which I didn't get before. But anyways, now on to the next part of this video. Okay, so for this part I'm gonna be showing you how to get Bloody Glory. Not Morning Glory, but rather Bloody Glory. Now, first you're gonna need the Pilgrim's Perch key, which you can purchase from Stowmund in, the hub area, I guess. And this area is pretty much accessible very early on in the game, and this will show you how to get one of the best weapons in the game if you are wanting to go for the Radiant build.
Why are you running?
But I did not say that getting there will be very easy. So, fast forward a little bit, let's get back to where we were, go through all these enemies, try not to engage them, remember to always jump, otherwise if you land in there it's going to be a large pit of death and you do not want to go down there. Roll through this barrel, hit through it, whichever, I don't care. Then just continue through all these mobs, go, 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 go. There is one part where you might fall into that area there to the right, however, do not go in there. It is also death, and screw this guy in particular. But okay, then you're going to want to head on outside and make a hard left. Go, 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 and dodge the man with the crossbow. My gosh, those guys are so annoying. And then keep on going through. Go, 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 go. And you'll get into another cave system. Then you're going to want to go up this ladder. Go, 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 go. And then keep on going. And then there's two enemies up ahead, but I would recommend just rolling past them.
Stop right there, criminal scum.
And try not to Velcro onto one of them. So you're almost there. Just keep on going. And at this part, there is actually a small mini-boss to the left. However, we do not want to go there. So rather, make a hard right by this big, very large statue. And then make another hard right, ignoring the dude there. Watch out for the crossbow dude yet again. And then after this, you're going to come face to face with one of the most annoying early game enemies there are. These guys with the big helmets. However, this particular one, as you've just seen with my ultimate demise, this guy in particular went to the gym 5 times every day with a lot of creatine and a lot of steroids, and clearly it's worked out for him. So, yeah, best steer clear from him. But here we are, trying again, and he's not letting up, so just run away from him. However, if you want to see how strong this weapon is, then let's quickly see how much damage it does. Whoa, okay, always try to dodge that one, and we've got around a lot of damage. Not only does it do a lot of holy damage and physical damage, but it also does 300 bleed damage. Now, if you've played Elden Ring, you would know that dealing bleed damage is pretty much OP. You can't go wrong with it. Almost all the bosses are not resistant to bleed damage in Elden Ring. And most of the time, same goes for this game. So you'll see here I'm using also Pieta's sword, the so-named short sword, however it's far from short, as well as Bloody Glory, with Bloody Glory being in the right and Pieta's sword being on the left. Pieta's sword, of course, is very easy to obtain once you defeat Pieta. You can just offer her remembrance and then you will get access to the sword. However, you do need a bit of radiance to do it. Now, this is the location for Pieta, Bloody Glory. This one to the right of the little statue going to the Umbral Realm. So first go into that if you want. And then I will show you here where Bloody Glory is. So not this one, as I initially thought, but rather the one right next to it. There we go. So this one where you see a large dead man who looks like he fell from above, that is where you will find Bloody Glory. Okay. So, now for this segment, I'm going to show some of my stats. So, I use Bloody Glory +4 and Pieta's short sword, also +3. And they're not very much upgraded. and they're doing pretty well so far. So you'll see there it has a D ranking in strength and B in radiant. However, as you scale those up, it will then also go up. My strength is 27 and radiance is 40. So that is where the pack-a-punch comes from. But alright everyone, that is it. Sorry for wasting your time with a lot of meme videos and not being able to show you how to get large amounts of delirium shards. But unfortunately they patched it. But anyways, hope you enjoyed. Cheers.